Okay, guys, so now we're gonna go over a guard pass, very, very common guard pass. I'm gonna show you guys a little detail that's gonna save you guys a ton of headache, a ton of problems. And I see this happen all the time when guys are doing this guard pass. The guard pass we're gonna work on is the one where you kind of slide the knee through the legs. And a lot of times, it's either from standing up here and you start to put your knee through, or maybe in a closed guard like this, and you start to turn your hip and you start to bring your leg through. So any of these knee slide through passes, right, what happens a lot of times is a person ends up trapping your foot here. Usually when I do this type of pass, when I slide through with a knee, I always like to have the underhook, right? This prevents the guy from taking my back. Even from here, if I have this grip, if the guy knows how to move, you see, if he turns his shoulders, he can end up taking my back. So anytime I go for a knee slide through, I always grab the underhook to prevent the person from taking my back. Now the big problem here when people slide the knee through is they end up putting their knee on the ground. And if you come around here and look at my foot, what you'll see is you'll see the problem. So my foot back here is stuck between his legs, okay? And I can't really finish my pass because what happens is when the legs are closed, there's a very narrow slit between the legs. And my foot is jammed like this. So basically I'm banging into a wall, right? So the idea for me, when I start to slide my knee through, when I want to pass, I don't want to have my knee on the ground. What I'm going to do is I'm going to turn my hip, okay? So now what you can see is my foot, once I turn my hip, you can see how my foot starts to turn, okay? So instead of having it like this, where I'm stuck, my heel and my foot is stuck, look what I'm going to start to do. I start to turn my foot, okay? So the key to sliding the foot out is this. What I want to do is I'm going to turn my hip up towards the ceiling to slide my foot out. So anytime I do this guard pass, and it can be from maybe he's got his legs in here and I'm already starting to put my, see, this is very common. Puts the knee inside to jam my hip, right? So of course I can't slide through. So look what I'm going to do. From here, I don't try to go through his knee, I just turn my hip to already kill his leg. So from here, right, you see this happen all the time. Guys do this, and of course he's going to block with the knee, okay? So I'm not going to try to go through it. What I'm going to do is I turn my body and collapse this leg. Now what happens is he's going to try to hold on for dear life. He's going to hold on to that foot for dear life because I'm almost passed. Now he's like, no, there's no way you're going to pass. There's no way you're going to pass. So look what I'm going to do. See how this foot is stuck? Once I turn my hip up, my foot's just going to slide out. Very difficult to stop. It's basically like fitting a key through a keyhole, right? I just have to turn it so it fits right through the hole. My foot is very narrow, right? Narrow here and then wide there. And same with the hole between the legs. It's very narrow. So that's the idea, is I want to fit my foot through the hole, and especially when things get slippery, if my foot gets slippery or whatever, it's much easier. No gi, it's even easier, right, to slide it through. So from here, a lot of times, you know, I pass, I open the legs, right, and I'm going to start to come here with my knee to pass. He's going to block me with this leg, of course. So the main thing is getting this underhook so he can't take my back. And now look, I'm going to start to turn my hip and collapse that leg, okay? So I'm not resisting anything. I'm not trying to go through anything. I'm just using my body here to collapse. Now what he's going to do is he's going to try to hold on to that leg, right? So from here, I'm just going to control his elbow to keep him flat. And now look, I turn my hip up towards the ceiling, and my foot will slide out. So you guys can try that. Instead of putting your knee on the ground, which most people do, they end up putting their knee on the ground and their foot ends up stuck and then they can't move. You want to engage your body weight, put your weight on your opponent, turn your foot all the way, turn your hip so it's facing up towards the ceiling to free the foot, and that will save a lot of you guys from being able to have problems pulling your leg out. So here's the thing, a lot of people with this pass, once they bring the knee through and the guy catches the foot, what they try to do is they try to use this leg to push back, to kick back, instead of just turning the hip on top. So you can do that, but it depends on how strong the guy is and depends on how good good of a grip he has on your foot. The other thing I don't really like about taking my foot off the ground and going like this is because if the guy straightens his body out, he can roll you to the other side. So I lose it, right? So from here, what I like to do is, you see how my hip, my knee actually comes off the ground. I turn my hip, so try to roll me to the other side. If he tries to roll me to the other side, my foot's just gonna come out. If I bring my foot, if I don't engage my hip, and I try to do this, as soon as he straightens his legs, look, I'm already going, right? So that's all he has to do. I try to kick here, straighten your whole body, keep your knees tight, boom. See that? How he's got my foot still? And now he's just gonna roll to the other side. So from here, control the elbow. When he starts to roll, you see how my hip engages and it turns. So keep my foot caught. And you can look from the back. If you look from the back, look what happens to my foot. Goes from this direction. As I start to turn and turn my hip, it just slides out. It's so easy. It feels like there's nothing even there. It feels like there's nothing even blocking my foot or keeping my foot caught, right? So that's just the difference between kind of turning your hip and sliding your foot through, or like a lot of guys try to either push, or here's the other option a lot of guys do, and it's not a bad option. From switching here, a lot of guys feel their foot gets caught, so they come back to the mount. But a lot of times what happens is, even when you mount, the foot still stays caught, right? The guy will just follow to the other side and keep your foot caught. So that's why I prefer, if I go to this side, why not just free the foot by turning your hip up towards the ceiling, right? Then once my foot is free, then I can kind of go back to whatever position I prefer.